Hi guys, welcome to Gardening Escape with Saurabh. Let's introduce you with my Barbados cherry tree I have since 2 years. It's behind me working as a background as you can see. You may ask, this is a common plant, what's this all about? Well, the difference is how I succeeded growing it in the same grow bag for 2 years and kept it fruiting like crazy. So let's have a look what I did to the plant. If we are growing plants in containers, first we need to prepare foundation properly. That means we have to work on encouraging vigorous root system. What I did right is choosing a grow bag over fancy pots. This guy produces roots really fast, so repotting can be a tough job. But what if the roots are air pruned automatically without need of repotting? Isn't that sounds great? Actually, when these roots come in contact with this grow bag, sunlight and heat burns them. This forces the plant to produce hairy feeder roots, and there's the most job done for better fruiting. Barbados cherry planted in ground fruits abundantly without any fertilizer, but proper feeding is very important for the plants grown in containers. I normally feed diluted mustard cake fertilizer followed by bone meal and neem cake mixture alternatively at every 20 days interval. If by any chance these fertilizers are not available in your area, you can go for vermicompost and water soluble NPK. They work just fine. This plant loves high potassium fertilizer at the time of flowering and fruiting. Foliar spray of NPK 0050 just before flowering did a great job for me. Till now, I have discussed about root growth and fertilization. Now, let's talk about vegetative part and when to prune this plant. This plant produces fruits on mature canes. More mature canes means more fruit. See the brown skin? That's mature cane, and the green skin is immature cane. So, how do you create more mature branch than immature ones? Simple, by pruning them every year. At the beginning of February, you can prune and save this plant. Don't prune again that year, as it may deny you fruits. This cherry variety doesn't have so many pests and diseases. Sometimes black and green aphid attacks can be seen. Spraying just neem oil will cure most of the pest attacks. Now the most irritating part. You have got a great looking bushy cherry plant, no disease at all. Flowers are there in huge number, but as soon as you are expecting huge fruiting, flowers start to drop. Usually, this happens in case of boron deficiency. Spraying micronutrient containing boron just before flowering corrects this problem. Sometimes, fruit drop happens after successful pollination. In that case, watering or spraying with NPK 0050 diluted in water prevents fruit drop. Guys, many of you may be experiencing that your plant is healthy but isn't producing any flower at all. Here's a secret tip for that. At very early morning, I mean within 6 a.m., spray any PGR all over the plant uniformly. 0.5 ml PGR into 1 liter of water is recommended dose. Any more than that can harm your plant. I hope flowering and fruiting problem will be solved if you do this correctly.
Let me know if you have any suggestion in the comments below. And if you are new, don't forget to subscribe Gardening Escape for more gardening tips and tricks. Thanks for watching. Stay fit and happy gardening.